Welcome to Sheena Power Talk Youth Link, where our redeemed, revived, and transformed guests get real and empowering the youth. I'm your host, Sheena Lynn Hansen, and I'm so happy to be with you here on Season 3, where God is doing an absolutely amazing thing. Today, I'm so happy and elated to have here with me Pastor ERROL White, and I know a lot of people been asking and anticipating his presence, and God would have it that he's here with us today. So go and get your aunties, your uncles, your sisters, and your brothers. Let them know that Pastor is in the building, and I want you to put in the comment section, how have this man impacted your life? I'm going to tell you how, but you must tune in. Now, we will be right back.
Sheena Power Talk.
And we arise and I take over territory. We are break some curses lyrically. We are shake some kingdom literally. Nah, show Satan no sympathy. Young people make we grow spiritually. Stop war with the neighbor physically. Draw for the Holy Bible daily. Humble a God feet like baby. Tired for the family in a cemetery. Youths them need guidance mentally. Stop abuse young girls sexually. We need Yeshua in the industry. Satan a try rob you of your destiny. Young girl, keep your identity.
Welcome, 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 man of God. How are you?
I am absolutely amazed. Yeah, one word name, appalled.
Yes.
Excited. Mm-hmm. To be here. I never normally do this. I don't like it.
Yes, sir.
Is my wife really pushing me?
Yes.
But I really I'm appreciative of being here because you have been doing a wonderful work. I always watch it. So I said, all right, next time she called, God.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. I really appreciate your presence here. And sir, you look really blessed, and I'm so happy. And I know a lot of people is very happy in the comment section right now. But sir, I must ask you, can you tell us 5 significant things about yourself?
Here I know, Jesus. Very kind, very humble.
Yes, sir.
Not talkative.
Mm-hmm.
What else again? No. Just nice.
Nice. Just nice.
Just to get along with.
All right. Just nice. Pastor is humble. He's nice. And listen, he's a power pop. He's a powerhouse. Let's not leave that out there. Now, sir, I believe that the Bible is the foundation of truth. What is your favorite scripture and what it means to you?
All right. My favorite scripture, Galatians 5:16. Really 16 through 18, but I just stick at 16.
Yes.
Galatians 5:16, it says, walk in the spirit.
Yes.
And you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh.
Yes, sir. And what does that mean to you? How does it apply to your very own life?
It means a lot to stay pure.
Yes.
Mm. And to exemplify what it means to be pure, and as you say, about purity, your lifestyle, your, everything about you, this just cap it off. Trust me, it does a lot for me. As I said to you before, it revolutionized my life to think different. It changed my mindset that I am at a different realm, and there's a different version of me than what it was before, even as a Christian.
Amen. Glory to God. You know, Pastor, I want to ask you, who was ERROL White before salvation? But I would want to take this opportunity to tell the people how I come in contact with you and what you have done for me through the Spirit of the Living God. So I remember meeting Pastor ERROL White at a church meeting. It was an all-night service. And I remember he was going down into deliverance prayer, because one thing I know about Pastor, that he does deliverance and he's effective and he walks in the spirit. So I remember he was going down in deliverance service, and I remember he said there's some Leviathan spirit that is holding on to somebody's finances, and in 3, 2, 1, somebody's going to scream out. And when he said that, I scream out, and lo and behold, I was the one that had to go through the deliverance that day and manifested some things. And let me tell you, people of God, you see, ever since that day, I'm not telling you, so me, I'm Bill Gates that day. But I tell you, ever since that day, my finances have never, ever been the same. And every time I see him, I try to remind him, but he don't remember. Because you're not going to remember all of the work where God used you for the sometime. But you know God gets the glory. So yeah. That's why I have to always remind him, because it did touch my life. God would have used him to change an aspect of my life. Sister, I thank you and I appreciate you. And I honor you. I'm always tuning. Like, I really appreciate the work that you do. So now, sir, who was Pastor Errol before salvation?
All right. Errol was someone that was molested from a child. Very molested. And every move, for about 3-4 years, every move that his mother moved him from one community to another, he was molested by females. Mm-hmm. So that opened a door for spirits to enter, being promiscuous. So many people think that females are the only ones that are promiscuous, mm-hmm. but it happens with men. Now, as Errol grew, what was transferred from somebody, he began to transfer to others. Mm-hmm. He was molested by a woman, not by a man. And that's why you find many people today that become homosexual. Majority of them were molested, but it's by who?
Yes, sir.
So if it was a male, then they have the tendency to molest other males or to do homosexual. If it's a female, then they will molest other females. So as I grow, about 14, 15, I begin to do the same to younger girls, mm-hmm. young at age. Mm-hmm. Then as I go, suicidal was a part mm-hmm. that had but masturbation, pornography never come. Mm-hmm. Errol was all over the place. He was in the army. Every go-go club, this man was at the front beating down the stage. Before him leave the go-go club, he had 4 go-go for the night when he think it was finished, because what was transferred in him mm-hmm. was just wanting more. Mm-hmm. So when he left the go-go clubs, he will go to New Kingston. If he's in New Kingston, if he's in Ocherais, if he's in Manchego Bay, he will go to the square. He will find prostitute, and he will have 3 prostitutes. After he finished with the 3 prostitutes, when he went to him, you think that's it, he will be satisfied. No, there was a stronger urge. There came Miss Palm and her 5 daughters.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So it was an ongoing thing. He was very loose, could not settle with anybody. Money was affected. Our education was affected because of that. Now, many people don't know that these things affect one's life. It affects your destiny. It cut short education. You will try to go to the highest institution, which I did at UTech, and by 2 subjects, I know.
My God.
Sister, until Jesus come in.
Sister, that is what I want to know. With all of that you've been through, how did Jesus came in and grab you? What was your salvation story?
All right. It wasn't at a church. I never got saved at a church. I never got filled at a church. God assigned this young man to me while I was in the army.
Mm-hmm.
I was very dirty, very nasty, very low, worse than a dog. Trust me, when we say worse than a dog, worse than a dog. So God assigned this young man to me. He was a Christian. We became good friends. Now I understand that everywhere I go, this young man would always be there. Mm-hmm. At a point in time, I'm wondering if this young man is really a Christian, because he's always there. Not understanding that God graced him to be there at my lowest point, even at times to commit suicide, he was right there. So God graced him, kept him for a period of time, about 5-6 years. I was loose. My mouth was dirty, filthy. And one day, this guy came to me while at work, and he said to me, "The Lord said that the foot I have outside with you, I should take it in. That my work in you is completed. So I must take my leave and go. So everything you need now to accept him as your Lord,
yes.
I've done my work." The guy walked out of the room,
mm-hmm.
just left me like that. So I'm saying, "All right, fine, me find somebody else, mm-hmm. no problem." So while they're sitting, I don't know what happened. I don't know. If I tell you, I don't know. But somebody entered the room.
Yes, sir.
And I don't know, I just feel overwhelmed. And I started to cry. Big, bad, bad word, cursor, woman, this, that. Just started to cry. I melt like a baby. I weeped. I don't know what happened. And then I said, Lord, I am ready. I'm going to give you 1 year, just 1 year. If everything this man says about you, I don't see it in my life, I'm going to take back my life and I'm going to do road.
Mm-hmm. Sister,
Just like that. The following Sunday, I tell him, I'm coming to church.
Mm-hmm.
When I went to church, the preacher didn't have to preach for me.
Mm.
By the time he finished preach, I walked to the altar.
Mm-hmm.
He said, why are you here? I said, I'm ready to give Jesus my life. I'm ready to give him a chance in my life.
Mm.
So this man tell me some things about him. I want to see them in my life.
Yes.
And I said, okay, no problem.
Mm-hmm.
So he went to, you know, them have this candidate class for them carry through.
Mm-hmm.
For me, trust me, me not think it necessary.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody ready to be baptized, baptize them once there's water.
Mm-hmm.
Just like with, I think it's Philip, with the eunuch.
Yes.
Where there is water, once they are ready, baptize them.
Yes, sir.
After, take them through your classes.
Mm-hmm.
So through the classes, there are many times I almost go. The last time was like, for example, tomorrow is the baptism. Mm-hmm. The Saturday night weather class.
Yes, sir.
Pastor finished. I left. Everybody was, no, they went back in the church. I was standing at the gate. I kissed my teeth. I said, me not bother with this.
Mm-hmm.
So while I was standing at the gate, a voice began to speak to me.
Mm.
And the voice said to me, they don't care. God don't care. Nobody cares. Might as well just go back to live your own life. He said, as a matter of fact, tell you what, since nobody cares about you, go and kill yourself right now.
Jesus.
I stand at the gate for some time. Then I said, how can I do that? I'm reasoning with the voice. The voice said to me, all right, this is what you do. Go out to Waltham Park. No, it says, go to Pegasus. Remember, you have access to go in and you can go on the roof. We have been there already. Jump. I said, what if I don't die?
Mm-hmm.
And I just break my bone and creep. He said, I don't want that. He said, all right, tell you what you do. Go out to Waltham Park Road. Walton Park, Ugly Park Road. Stand. I will tell you when to step.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever comes, that's it. It finish.
Mm. So, sir, you are having a conversation with a spirit of suicide.
Yeah.
My God.
I have some of that to talk about.
But, sir, that's the reality of a lot of persons now. So, if you could even just share with us.
I have a whole,
I have quite a few to share with that.
So watch this. Mm-hmm. So while I was walking up the road, I begin to cry. I said, God, if you don't want me, then nobody don't want me. Let me go. So I said, yeah, man, don't listen to nobody. Just go. When I was going up the road, yes, I hear a voice say, young man. I turned. It was a pastor.
Yes.
I turned. Him said, where are you going? You're not staying. We have something to share with you. I said, it don't make no sense. Him said, come here. Then I turned back. Then he asked me what happened. I was telling him. Then he said to me, okay, it's because your star is very bright.
Mm.
Him said, your star is very bright. So the enemy wants to cut you off before you reach there. Then he said, come, let me talk to you. Sit with me, talk to me a little while. Then I got baptized. You know how much time? It was about 7 to 8 times I tried to commit suicide, all while I was saved too.
Mm.
So, I didn't even want to jump to that. But guess what? No. What I understand, there's a lot of stuff I understand from that, is that when we talk about thought, it's not really a thought, it's a talk. A thought is really a talk. In the realm of the spirit, there is no thought, only in time. So in the realm of the spirit, it's talk. Everybody hear everything. So if God says something about you, everybody hear, good and bad, angels and demons hear. And that's why when something good is about to happen to somebody or a prophecy is released over somebody, it's a major talk. talk, a proclamation in the realm of the spirit. So demons hear and they say, we can't allow this to manifest. So we can't stop it. So this is what we will do. We'll go down and we'll frustrate the person till their life becomes nothing and the prophecy fail. There are some people that get prophecy that should have happened a week, a month, 2 weeks before, and it don't manifest till 6 years, 7 years. They're rejoicing. No, don't rejoice. Don't rejoice. So a thought is really a talk, because when the thought comes to us, is really a talk. Somebody is talking. So behind every thought is a voice, and behind every voice is a spirit. So if somebody is not grounded on the word of God and understand the difference between flesh and spirit, they will hear flesh speaking or a spirit speaking and think it's the Holy Spirit or an angel when it's not. So we have to learn to differentiate, and that's where purity comes right in. We can't live our lives just to say, hey, I learned some stuff. Jesus, I learned some stuff. And most of the stuff I learned is in my dream.
Thank God.
I will listen to men of God, but most when it comes to deliverance, my wife can tell you, it's in my dream. Everything about deliverance is in my dream. How to pull like sickness from people's body is in a dream where this angel was standing with me and he shows me the person. He takes me to hospitals, various, name the hospital, St. Thomas, all of them. But I believe it's churches, because churches represent hospital. So he took me to them. Doctors took me to the ICU units, the wards, and I will just go and touch people. Some I will just pull. So he says, this is how you do, because most of what people are experiencing are arrows. That's what they call most sickness are arrows, arrows, arrows. So you show me how to go and to pull like a pulling needle.
Yes.
Right, and pull. And trust me, most of the people, one lady, I said to her, she had a pinched nerve where she couldn't move her hand, her neck, something like that. Everything just when she moved, sticking. I said to her, tell your pinched nerve. Say, pinched nerve? She said after me. I said, say after me. Pinched nerve, this is the last time you're going to pinch me. She said, and I said, tell him, I am going to pinch you now 3 times. And when I pinch you, you will leave my life. And I said, pinch it. And she pinched 3 times.
Yes.
After, she has never been affected, never go to doctor concerning pinched nerve.
My God, so that arrow had come out.
Right. So a thought is really a talk. Oh. And when Christians understand that, they won't entertain certain thoughts. Because if a thought is a talk or a voice, and behind every voice, there is a spirit. So when depression comes to talk you down and tell you that you can't make it and tell you that people don't see you like this and how you see yourself, you're not that. That's a talk. That's somebody talking. So that's depression. It can be this voice that says to you that, you know, see, nobody loves you. Nobody, even at the church, if you look, you see how they look at you. Nobody's looking at you, no. But they tell you, look at how they look at you when you come in. Look how you're dressed. Look how they look. No, it's very few people talk to you. And they just talk to you because you just come to church. But they really don't mean. And so watch this now. Behind that thought is a voice speaking. Behind that voice is a spirit. And that spirit is rejection.
Sir, that used to happen to me a lot.
Right, that's rejection. So rejection makes you begin to look down at yourself because you was rejected. I know what rejection is. I can tell people. So what I went through now, God is using me to help other people. I was rejected. I was rejected from I was in the womb. I was rejected by my father. I love to tell the story sometime in the new first, but I'm just talking. I said, how I came about is a one-night stand. I am a one-night stander. You understand? Now I can joke about it. You understand?
Yeah.
After 48 years, I get to understand who is my father. He died over how much years, but I get to understand. It settles me. It settles me. And now what used to happen, I see his children now, some of them trying to do it, to reject me, to say, I am not there, this and that. It doesn't matter one iota to them now, because I've been through it, I've been ill. Mm-hmm. I just want to know that I know who my father is. I was called Bright. My name was ERROL Bright. Mm-hmm. That's what I born getting, ERROL Bright. Really, I'm a white. Now, as ERROL Bright, there was some stuff that affected my life, my growth, my destiny, my future. Now, watch this. Because I don't know who my father is, there are things from my father's side that was fighting my life, mm-hmm. limiting my life, and I did not know. One of them is, this is my second marriage. One of them is marriage is under problem. When I check his side, marriage is a All of the siblings married 2, 3, 4 times. Some of them, they trust me. So marriage don't last. A marriage is not good. So I didn't know that. So my first marriage mashup. Then a lot of stuff I see happening in the thing. Oh man. So I was fighting stuff that I didn't know where it was coming from. Mm-hmm. I learned all of those things. Let me just get to something here and share. Kaya Basata. Hey, don't stir me up, please.
I won't stir you up, sir. Today is the day.
No, there's a passage of scripture that I love.
Yes, sir.
Apart from Galatians 5:6, I'm going to get back there quick. But it's St. John 10 and verse 10. The other day I was in Linstead, Bagwalk, preaching. And trust me, the Lord just revealed this to me. It says, let me use King James. It says, verse 10, the thief cometh not, but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. So that's the role of the thief. So once there's something that you find robbing out of your life in terms of like not having, let me tell you now, having been blocked or stopped at the edge mm-hmm. of miracles, of breakthrough, of testimonies, mm-hmm. that's a thief. A thief is there somewhere because yeah. he steals. So every time something good is about to happen to you, yes. it shows up. Mm-hmm. And to kill, everything that you want to do and to be is there to ensure that it never manifests, never be fruit. So what this does, you know, is affect a person's life. You know, it affects your character. It affects your, what should I say, no? Your value or your belief. So if every time you start something good and something up and it never come out, then, you know, after a time, you just don't want to bother do anything. Mm-hmm. You can't bother with the fight. So it devalue you and you're not thinking positive anymore. You're withdrawn. But those are spirit. And I always tell people, fear is the main spirit. Fear of feeling, fear of this, fear. Before any spirit can enter, fear is the main one. Mm-hmm. Fear is a man that enters and opens the door for every other spirit. That's what he does. So he said to kill and then to destroy. Jesus said, I am come that they might have life. And they might have and enjoy life, says the Amplified. I love that part. Mm-hmm. So they might have and enjoy life. I love that. Now Jesus said, I am come. Now some people read this, when they say, I am come, they are looking at 2,000 years ago when Jesus come. Mm-hmm. And that's not what he's saying. The thief comes in order to steal, kill. Jesus said, I am come. If you notice, he never said, I have, mm-hmm. I will, mm-hmm. I'm about to. He said, I have come. It means presently, mm-hmm. in the midst of the thief, stealing, killing, destroy, he comes to change all of that. Now, many people, this is what with Christian women don't like now. We are the one that allow thieves, the thief to enter.
Yes, sir.
By come back again, we refuse to be pure. We refuse to be separated. Many people look at holiness as doing something and dressing away and conducting it. That's not what holiness is. Me very sorry. Mm-hmm. That's what holiness means, separation. It means separated from and separated to. It said, we say God is holy, right?
Yeah.
What does it mean by God is holy? Remember, God is a spirit, so God can do things and so forth. But when it says God is holy, it means is everything that is sinful or so, God is separate from it. God remains separate. So you can say God is pure.
Aye.
So we too, when it means holy, it means that the minute we were born again, we were born from above, born with the nature, the spirit nature of God. So immediately we become holy, we become separated from everything that we were to something new like God.
Yes.
And that's what holiness is, and that's what purity is. And for me, no, I don't work to be holy. I don't do things to be pure.
Mm-hmm.
I am pure, so I am maintaining a life of purity, a life of holiness. How do I do that? One, reading the Word of God, spending time with somebody who is holy,
mm-hmm.
spending time, prayer, which keeps me. So some people, again, another thing that Christian look at, when he talks about he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High, people think it's a place you go. It's not a place you go.
Yes, sir.
It's not a place you go. So they look for a place and say, set up altar. You don't need no altar.
Mm-hmm.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High, watch this now. The Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature altogether. The old as gone, removed, but you have to believe it, and the new has come. So the new means I am holy, I am righteous, I am set apart, I am sanctified only for God. So everything that is not of God, my job is to set boundaries so they don't come inside of my circle called righteousness and holiness. That's all it means, you know. So people are trying to, now because I am holy, because I am righteous, I enjoy reading the Word of God. I enjoy, so I don't do it to become holy, because some people believe if they don't read a scripture, that's why in the morning you can get up and you cannot read your Bible for 1 week and you're still holy and you're still righteous.
Mm-hmm.
Some people, if they don't read it in the morning, they feel guilty for the whole day. They feel like they sin wrong.
Mm-hmm.
He that dwelleth in the secret, so my body now becomes the temple or the house for God.
Yes, sir.
So God means God dwells here.
Yes.
So my job is to dwell in his presence daily. So I must know that he is here. I don't feel.
Mm-hmm.
Because situation can bring about where it don't feel like. You're nowhere near God.
Mm-hmm.
There are some things, which is, you know that people can sin and still be in the presence of God. Watch him, look for me now.
Mm-hmm.
All the viewers, them are watch me. That's why I tell people at the church that I used to pastor, I tell them, don't let what you do affect who you are.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a holy, righteous people that makes an error and a mistake. This part that you're on, it's a journey. It's a pathway.
Jesus.
It's a journey too. On the pathway, the enemy will set snares and traps for you to fall. When you fall, it is designed for you to go back to where you're coming from. But when you understand that you are God's child and your steps are ordered, you will blunder, God, you will get up, God will brush you. That's why 1 John, is it 1:9? If you, oh God, confess your sin, he is faithful and just to again to cleanse you
mm-hmm.
and to from all unrighteousness. You see it? Once you say, Daddy, I fall here. It's a relationship. Daddy, I fall here. Man, I'm sorry.
Yes.
Help me. Help me to grow past this. Thank you, Daddy. And you get up and continue.
Yes, sir.
But when you continue, rest assured, the enemy going to tell you, you're sure he'll forgive you.
Mm-hmm.
You're sure this and that.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody go talk about your praise and worship. Remember what you do last night.
Yes. Oh my God, sir, this is so deep. Is I'm going to take a commercial break and come right back.
Sheena Power Talk.
gang, remember to get your book on Amazon today. No other day but today. You can get it in Kindle form and you can get it in paperback form. And if you are in Jamaica and you want a copy of this amazing book, The Crown and the Cross, listen to me. Call me at 1-876-429-6004. Listen, Power Gang, you must have one of these books. Come on now, Crown and the Cross.
Welcome back. I hope you have your notepad and your pen writing down. You know, I miss nothing. Put some of the nuggets that Pastor is sharing in the comment section and tell us how you are being impacted. Isn't this so good? Pastor, thank you so much. Continue.
So the thief only comes in order to steal, kill, and destroy. So he sets traps, pitfalls, temptations for us to fall. Remember, temptation is not sin. Temptation is not sin. Jesus was tempted in the wilderness to step down from who he really is. So temptation is to take you from out of the glory and to put you down. That's what temptation comes to do. Trust me. Jesus, God say, when he was baptized, when he come up, now look at this glorious thing that happened. The heavens open over Jesus. John saw this. And then John said, the dove, there's a dove. Now watch this. The Holy Spirit is not a dove.
Aye.
The Holy Spirit is not a dove. Just as a dove, when he's landing, a pigeon, just look at them. I love to look at them. When they are landing to eat, they come with their wings out. I don't know how them do with the wind, just like the plane coming down. And they will descend and just stop on the tree or whatever. Them. He said, that's how the Holy Spirit comes. When he saw, there are some spiritual things you see that you can't explain it in the natural for people to understand. So for those around, this is how John could only explain it. The Holy Spirit, I saw him coming in the farm. He just lands gently at you. He lands gently. So he comes down gently on Jesus. So he can't say, there's a force, there's a power that comes on. So he said, the Holy Spirit, like unto a dove, come and descend upon him. So one, it shows you that Jesus helped me here. Watch this. When a person gets baptized, the minute you go into the water and the minute you comes up, there's an open heaven over your head.
Yes.
Jesus is our example. Nobody teaches us that when we get saved after baptism, there's an open heaven. The atmosphere of heaven is open and ready. How do I, and watch this, when the atmosphere of heaven is open, their angels are ascending and descending to help you. Nobody teaches us that. Mm-hmm. So we just get saved, become a member, and the heavens is there and we're not doing anything. Second, the Holy Spirit comes down to descend, to sit, to reign. Watch this now. So I tell people there are three baptisms for every Christian. Some people wonder how. We don't know one, we know two. When you repent, then them say you're baptized in the water. The first baptism is when you get saved. That's repentance. Mm. Just as though the Holy Spirit come down on Jesus. The first baptism for every Christian is a baptism into Christ and into the body of Christ. That means at that moment you were translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light. Everything about you becomes light. Everything about you becomes holy. Everything about you becomes pure, irrespective of all the hell you've been through, irrespective of all the old dirty things that people will say about you. The minute you do that, you are baptized into Christ. Remember now, into Christ, who is all righteous, all holy, all pure. You have been baptized into Christ. That means, bam, nobody sees you anymore. Your life, it's Christ's life now that surrounds you. So that's the first baptism, and the first agent of the baptism is the Holy Spirit. So when you get saved, the Holy Spirit comes on the inside, and His job is to replicate the character and the glory of God in your life.
Yes, sir.
That's the first one. Now, that is where you call that you are saved. Then now, you are qualified for baptism, watery baptism. Mm-hmm. It's only saved people get baptized. And that's what we want to tell people. Now, baptism, the agent for that is a man.
Yes.
So it's a pastor, a prophet, whoever is designated to do that, that's the, a man. Mm-hmm. The third baptism now is into the Holy Ghost mm-hmm. and with fire. And that is power or endowment from heaven so that you can live a victorious, a pure, a P-U-R-E, pure life.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
So baptism in the Holy Ghost is not only for tongue speaking. It's far deeper than that.
Yes, sir.
When the baptism of the Holy Ghost comes, man, take her. Heaven is open at your beckon. Demons tremble when a believer is baptized in the Holy Ghost and with fire. They quake, but they don't want us to know that. So they make us believe that we are just normal tongue-speaking person. Some people don't understand. Watch this. When you start praying in tongues, you're praying in tongues, then you do something like this. They don't understand what just happened. You have just switched realms. You have just been elevated from one realm to another. Every time your tongue shift or change, it means that God has elevated you from one realm to another. So people just think that a Christian life is just normal, you see? And that's a problem. And that's a problem.
My God.
No, there are other scriptures, but because of a lack of knowledge, tell me if may answer everything we want to know. Yes. Because of a lack of knowledge, people are opening doors daily, allowing the thief inside. When we allow certain things, not of God, that we are wearing, as they become clothing, and as we continue in them, they become like animals. Our demons to rest upon us. I'm going to explain that. These come to corrupt or contaminate your holiness or your purity or your righteousness. It means that there are things that the Bible tells us to put off. When we continually to keep them on and to dabble in them and to mix, they become clothing. If you notice, The Bible talks a lot about white garment, clothing.
Yes,
that signifies righteousness, purity, and holiness. Now, when you do anything contrary to that, you are soiling the garment.
Yes, sir.
I've had a dream as a young believer, very young, whereby I saw the Lord coming for people. And the heavens was open. And there was angel with charts. And the people were coming in garments. And I stand with the angel. I was about to go. He said, no, stand here. I want to show you something. When I see the people come, I saw the spots. Some very small, some big, some this. And I'm saying, so what are these dots and soil on the garments? He said, let me open your eyes and let me see. When you look on the spots, you will see anger. You will see malice. You will see backbiting, you will see envy, you will see jealousy. So whatever they are in, you will see witchcraft, whatever, because some Christians work witchcraft hard, you know.
Yes, sir.
And some work witchcraft without knowing that they are working witchcraft.
Yes,
the minute you allow somebody else to let you talk about somebody, spite, ill will, spite, ill will. What these are is really spelling. We think spelling as we were taught in the natural, S-P-E-L-L-I-N-G, we're spelling words. But spelling really comes from people using their mouth and releasing words. That's spelling. And many Christians are spelling against their brothers and sisters in the church and not knowing that they are casting spells and open up portals for spirit to affect them. When somebody say, I don't like her, I hate her, what you are really doing is you are conjuring demons to attack the person's life and destiny. That's why the Bible talks so much about loving our neighbor.
Yes, sir.
And I hear a man of God say something. He said, you're not killing me inside here, you're not killing me. My, I understand God first, family, and then whatsoever church. So he was saying, my family, I don't care about no. My family comes first and so forth and so forth. But in a sense, watch this. Who is my family? No, in Christ. Mm-hmm. My family is not my family that I was born in.
Mm-hmm. Right.
My family in the house of God is my true family because we carry the same DNA now.
No.
Mm-hmm. I carry a stronger DNA through the blood of Jesus than my relatives.
Yes, sir.
And that's why when they come for Jesus and they say, your mother, your father, your siblings is outside. He said, who's my family? He said, these are my family. Mm-hmm. They that obey the word of God, these are my family.
Mm-hmm.
They become second hand.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, if watch is not because we are the same blood, we are in Christ, in God. So we carry the same DNA. So how now can I take my mouth and curse God's own?
My God.
So we're wrong. And because of that, many people in the church are doing witchcraft. So watch this. When they have the spots and it represents, the spots now becomes like clothing.
Yes, sir.
And it sits on the people. Then after a time, that same clothing now becomes like a demon, a principality.
Yeah.
It sits on you. It controls your life. If people walk in purity and practice, and we never say, perfection. Perfection is like Enoch and the rest. When you're perfect, God take you out. I'm talking about spiritual maturity.
Mm-hmm.
Maintaining a life of purity. When you maintain a life of purity, this is something that Christians don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
When you maintain a life of purity, the atmosphere of heaven is open over you. The intense loss of the Holy Spirit increases, it expands your spiritual man, whereby your eyes are now open to see. So while you're walking on the road, watch this. Some people don't know. So while they're walking on the road, while they're in a bus, while they're driving, there are angels that encamp round about them. There are angels that go before them to move out. There's, you know how much things could have happened to many of us? But the angels that are assigned, they go before, they overturn, they move this. So watch this. While angels are with us every day, while we go out, we come in back alive. Watch this. There are people, if our eyes are open, we will see demon leading many people on the road. Many people that are easily angry, you will walk, you see somebody just walk, and you just get angry. You bounce them and you say, oh, I'm sorry, sorry. And the amount of expletive and thing. If you could ask the Lord, the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, open my eyes, let me see. Immediately you will see this demon.
Mm-hmm.
Anger, wrath, murder, just on them. And you say, wow. And that's why I try my best. I try my utmost best. I make mistakes. Let me tell you, no, I make mistakes. I'll be driving on the road and many times I'm tempted. Somebody bad drive me. Sometimes I drive up for just look on their ugly face and their tough face. And for sure, their face look like their car front. And I say, yes, so your face favor your car front. That's why you call your forehead big.
Mm-hmm.
One day I'm driving and this man, Jesus and peace, the man roll me off the road. And when I see him, I said, but look at this big old B man. And when we say, hear me, Lord have mercy, Father forgive me, please. But you know, one true, in my one big B man for true. So I made errors. It's not that I'm free from errors. No, we are never be. Sometimes some people drive me to the point. That's me hear the big old bad word. Me check say. And some Christian will drive you to the edge.
True.
Some of them are assignment.
Yes, sir.
To drive you to the edge. So don't feel that I don't have these thoughts or they don't come to me. Because the enemy can only tempt you based on your past and where you're coming from, where you were held in prison.
Mm-hmm.
So I was held in prison by well, let me just go.
Sure, no. Why?
Jesus said, I am come.
Mm-hmm.
Not 2,000 years. No. So whatever is holding your back, whatever is fighting your life, as you are listening, Jesus said, I am come. Right now, Panshina, power talk. Jesus is here.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus said, I am come to deliver you, to set your life free. Whatever sin you feel, you can't stop doing. Jesus said, I am come. I guarantee you, by you finish listening this program, some things are going to leave your life.
Glory to God.
Some struggles that you have, mm-hmm. some doors that was closed is about to be mm-hmm. opened. Jesus said, I am come right now that you might have and enjoy life to the overflow, yes. abundantly, to the overflow, to the full. Mm-hmm. So Jesus said, I am come. And when I enter you, guess what? The life that I bring is going to overflow into your family, into your friends, mm-hmm. into your neighbor. Amen. We are opening doors that we shouldn't. Yes. We don't want to go there, but can I just say, as it in my system, let it jump out of my heart. I have seen a lot of Christians following fashions of the world. When we talk about fashion, me know me talk about fashion. We understand. Once you allow the Holy Spirit, who is pure, he will guide you.
Come on,
the church that I was, I have a guy that was dreadlocks. Mm-hmm. I never one day tell this guy to trim. Up to today, he don't trim. Mm-hmm. And this is one of the best Christian guy I have. Mm-hmm. So I do have no problem with ear. So leave me alone.
Sir, talk about it.
So I'm talking about watches. Mm-hmm. The piercing of the nose and the piercing of the top of your ear. Be very careful. The piercing of the nose, it has to do with, Lord have mercy. If you check back Bible days, when the priest, there were certain temple that was designed. Nose ring is prostitution. Nose ring, it identifies, it tells you who you are. The top of the ears is saying you are bisexual.
Sir, my appear talk about it, because just the other day, I say, no man, when I can't let go. See that little earring at the top of my ears, and I nose, but
I saw my daughter with one up at the top. I said, sweetheart, do you know what that means? Me say, you're telling people that you're bisexual, you go both ways.
And I'm, they know it's true, Pastor, because I know the enemy that put that in my mind.
Yeah. All right, watch this now. Some of the things that you hear me say, I learned through deliverance. I was praying for this young lady. While I'm praying for this young lady, I said, have you put piercings or tattoo on your body? She said, no. Me say, are you thinking about it? She said, yes. Me say, what is it that tells you? By time I said that, the girl head just pinned, my God, like Beetlejuice. Mm-hmm. And her eyes rolled over and changed. Mm-hmm. And she made a stand with her feet here. And I said, oh, you're from the Marine Kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
And she, that's why I tell her not to come here today, and I tell her not to come here, and she still force and come here, but she love you. She love you. She love you. I hate you.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. Right, tell me what you have been telling this girl. Do you know who I am? I said, no. Tell me who you are. I'm Cleopatra. I'm Cleopatra. I'm one of the goddess from the sea. I'm one of the princess. Talk to this and that, and she begin to name her. And baby. And this is my girl.
Mm-hmm.
We have her.
Mm-hmm.
I said, what did you tell her to do? I said, I told her to put tattoos and piercings on her body. Where did you tell her? Then she tell me exactly.
Mm.
Let me tell you why some people put tattoo at certain place. It's a spirit called exposure. That means they have to wear certain clothes pulled down in order for the tattoos to be revealed.
Yes, sir.
So it's a spirit. It's a spirit.
Sir, talk about it.
Let me get to something. If I can find it, let me get to something.
Yes.
I never meant to talk about that.
My God.
I'm never meant to talk about that. But let me tell you. And then he began to tell her where to put the tattoo, where to put the body piercing. I said, then why should she put one here? Because she's mine. She's mine. I sent ladies to her. I said, what you're not saying?
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that after the deliverance, and think the girl confessed, that she 1, 2, 3, or 4 times she had sex with woman?
My God.
So the nose piercing that she put here is to say you're advertising mm-hmm. something without talking.
My God, sir.
I said, really? She said, yes. And I told her, she said, it's okay if she have here, but I told her to put one here, one right here. This now tells her and attracts people that are bisexual.
Jesus.
I said, what are you saying, dear? And I tell her where to put the certain tattoo and the certain thing. She should pierce her navel and she should pierce her vagina, this and that. I say, what you're saying? And she said the piercing of the tongue has to do with when she's having sex with her partner, what do you call it? The clitoris, something like that. Yes. I said, see the church here?
Yes, sir.
I say, what you say?
Sir, sometimes when I listen to these deliverance, I wish I had come across people that knew of deliverance before. Because all of that I did, the piercing, the mouth, the tongue, everywhere.
My friend, you might hear about her, Prophetess Shanika Sutan.
Yes.
She tells her people all the while about me. She said, this is where I go to learn deliverance. She said, when I went the first time and see a poverty-stricken demon talking, the demon kick over the offering plate, kick over the pan with the plate, and say, no, she's not supposed to this, I'm not supposed to. I said, why then are you? Why? And she begin to talk. And she said, I've never seen that. One prophet came from overseas with Pastor Otis Manning, came to the church, and when he saw the demon kick the offering bucket, money spill all over, and he began to talk to him, hey, I'm a prophet. How many years? I've never seen this yet. Never. All right. Help me, Holy Ghost. I want to just get this to go by. But as I talk, I will just get to it.
Yes, sir.
Right? Because I want to let people know that people that pierce.
Can you really be free from all these steps?
Yes.
That we've
yes.
Done?
Yes. Yes. Without removing them. Without removing them. I never send anybody to go and remove anything from them. If we go spend money again. No.
Because I have an explicit tattoo on my body. And it makes me very uncomfortable.
Just get the olive oil. By you using the olive oil that represents the blood of Jesus. And you rub. Father, in Jesus' name. As I rub this oil, it represents the blood. Let it erase. So the tattoo will be there, but the significance of what it attracts, it breaks it.
Yes, sir.
Because it is there to attract or to say something.
Yes.
So your life will always, everywhere you go, it's like an antenna on your body that attracts certain spirits.
Mm-hmm.
You could do good, you could be good, but this like an antenna attract. My wife has a Tweety bird right here.
Mm-hmm. So, sir, can it influence bad dreams as well, the tattoos?
It can do a lot.
Mm-hmm.
It can do a lot because it is who influenced to put it on.
Mm-hmm.
And they put it on for a specific reason.
Yes,
and that's why I like prostitutes, go-go dancers, and so they wear certain tattoos.
Yes.
I'm trying to find it here. I have it, you know. I have it, but I don't remember where I put it. But what it does, that's what it is. I don't remember if it's this it's in. I will find it. Holy Spirit, thank you. I will find it. Don't worry.
Sir, thank you for sharing.
And I will go. So I will find it. It is here. I have it.
Yes,
so people don't. So you see, the thief comes for these reasons.
Yes,
and we don't know. We are ignorant, lack of knowledge. And that's why I teach all I teach.
Yes.
Trust me, for lack of knowledge, sometimes we perish. Trust me, we perish.
Yes, sir.
And I want to let people know. That's how I learn. I was talking about something when the first time. Oh, with it. Yeah, so that's the garment and what it does.
Yes.
It defiles and spirits are a track. I want to get to that and let people know that it's confusion.
Yeah.
It's a spirit of confusion that comes for piercings.
Yes, sir.
Now, this is what I want to share. Just beyond what your eyes can see, there is a very real spiritual world called the unseen realm, the spirit realm, or the supernatural realm. You can find this in 2 Corinthians 4:18, Colossians 3:1-2. I really don't want to get there just quick. I'm sure that I share one of them.
Yes, sir.
2 Corinthians 4:18. Let me see how fast we can do this. 2 Corinthians 4. And verse 18, that's at the bottom. 17, 18, it says, for our momentary light distress, this passing trouble is producing for us an eternal weight of glory, a fullness beyond all measure, surpassing all comparisons, a transcendent splendor, and an endless blessedness. So I'm telling somebody, whatever problem you're going through, the Bible called it momentary light distress. It's just a light distress. It's a passing trouble. Just like how certain storm come to do certain thing, it pass. Some of them just barely pass. So whatever you're going through, the Bible call it momentary. So look at it like that as a believer, and in the midst of it, God has made a way of escape. You yes. cannot fail. You are wired to win. Believe that. Put it in your head. You are wired to win. The DNA that God gives you is to win, is to overcome. That's why Romans 8, I think verse 37 said, nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors. It never say you're a conqueror, it say you are more than. Why no? 1 John 4, verse 4. Mm-hmm. It said, beloved, I try to remember how that one start, mm-hmm. but it said, you are children, you belong to God.
Yes.
Little children, thank you, Holy Spirit. Little children, you belong to God. And then it says something else. So it's three parts that one have. But we just take part C. Greater is he that is in me.
Mm-hmm.
No, part C cannot manifest or become activated until you believe part one and part two. Mm-hmm. Part one said, beloved, our little children, you are of God. So it's God making a statement.
Yes.
You are of God. You are not your own. You are not your mother or your father, Pitney. Know that you are in Christ. You belong to God. When you say you are of God, it means God take responsibility for your life now. So him say, you are of God. Then him say, no, because you are of God. Watch this now. And have overcome them. And have, not will, not is going to. So watch this. In the realm of the spirit, you are wired to win. You have already won every battle, every struggle.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter who tie you in any grave, tie your neighbor string on that tree or pantry. You are wired to win.
Hey, glory to God.
And at a point in time, you might be struggling, being held back, suffering because of lack of knowledge. But today, the Lord Jesus Christ has come and to tell you that you are wired to win. And every grave that they bury you in, that grave is about to open. It's opening right now. Everywhere any man has buried or tied your destiny, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command your destiny to arise and begin to locate you. Everywhere you are struggling and nobody sees you, good things pass you, man pass you. That is for marriage, successful marriage, potential future marriage. They come, they pass you, they come, they spend 3 months, they spend 6 months. In the name of Jesus, whoever has veiled your star, whoever is troubling your star, whoever is manipulating your star, in the name of Jesus, wherever they are, I release Holy Ghost fire now. I release Holy Ghost fire. I remove every veil from your star. I declare that people that should have helped you 20 years, 10 years, 5 years should have helped you from January, that somehow they said yes, they will help you. All of a sudden they go silent. I declare today that Jesus has come and those people will arise and come now.
Ooh, Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Man of God, just before we go further, we're going to take a commercial break and come right back.
Sheena Power Talk.
Hey Power Gang, remember to get your book on Amazon today. No other day but today. You can get it in Kindle form and you can get it in paperback form. And if you are in Jamaica and you want a copy of this amazing book, The Crown and the Cross, listen to me. Call me at 1-876-429-6004. Listen, Power Gang, you must have one of these books. Come on now, Crown and the Cross.
Guys, if you are this far in the video, I hope that you have liked, shared, and subscribed, and just open the channel of your spirit to receive, because I'm telling you, so much power. The wealth of the anointing is in the house, and it's the anointing that breaks the yoke. Pastor, continue.
Hallelujah. Yeah, man. So, oh God, please let me find it. Oh.
So, sir, you touch a a powerful mm-hmm. topic, and that was the piercing.
Yeah, I want to find it.
A lot of Christians are getting comfortable.
Yes, very comfortable. Piercing. Yeah, because people is telling them it's normal, and God looks at the heart.
Mm-hmm.
And God looks at the heart and not at what you do. But trust me, that is something that take time, pull them back. Mm. Pull them back out of purity.
Ah.
Those are designed to contaminate
yes.
your anointing, your grace.
Glory to God.
Mm. All right. It's here, no, it's here. I just remember where I put it in. I will find it. It's something that has to do with, oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. It is, okay, renewing my mindset to differentiate between voices. That's where it is.
Yeah.
Thank you. You see, oh God, you see the Holy Spirit go do. All right. Ela basatakan. Thank you, Jesus. All right. This is where I am. All right, come out of this now. You said something a little while.
Yes, sir.
You said something a little while. All right, let me go back. Oh, let me finish this point. So it says, whatever you're going through, the Bible calls it momentary light distress. It's light. It cannot hurt and kill you.
Mm.
The Bible gives us example. It said the Old Testament is examples for us to strengthen our faith
yes.
and not to sin. Now, watch this now. I understand this. Daniel was thrown in the lion den.
Yes, sir.
To show the den of lions that this one you can't kill.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter what was written or is written about you or has spoken over you. It can't kill you.
Right.
So Daniel was thrown in them to show that the God that Daniel served is bigger than the lion that should have ate him. Remember, a legislation was passed
yes.
that if him don't stop praying to him God, then he should die. So being thrown into the den of lion, it means death.
Mm-hmm.
But God showed death and the den of lion that this one, because of the DNA that he bears, you can't kill him.
Yes.
So you might go in the den where the lions are,
yes.
but they can't kill you.
Mm-hmm.
You find out that you sleep. And those who want to see you dead, the Bible say, them and the king was walking for the whole night praying. That means there are some people that put you in some position. There are some people that work some obi and some stuff and is looking on for shame, disgrace, and to see you die. The Bible says, I will keep them up nightly a watch.
Mm-hmm.
So they are waiting, watching for Daniel not to come. Then in the morning, the king said, oh, Daniel,
mm-hmm.
Daniel, man of God, is it that the God that you serve has kept you? And he said, oh, king, don't. I tell you, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was thrown into a fire. They were expecting death to be roasted. Watch this. The seven men, strong men, that bound them and threw them into the fire. It says they died.
Yeah.
That means there are some stuff that believers go through, and there's some stuff that you go through that people can't go through.
Yes.
Mm. They will get stressed, they will kill themselves, they will die. Yes. There are some things that Christians go through. Hey, someone will take some things for granted.
That's true, sir.
That certain people can't go through, they die.
Mm-hmm.
And in the midst of when they throw them, the king himself looked and said, did not we throw three? But I see four.
Mm-hmm.
And the next one is likened unto.
Mm-hmm.
Your momentary problem or your slight, your light distress
yes.
is to reveal the God that you carry and possess.
Amen.
So hold your forth. So verse 18 says, so we look not at the things. This is what I want to get to. So we look not at the things which are seen.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the problem. We love look upon the problem. And based upon the problem you see, you speak.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Whatever is happening, we practice to speak. No wonder why the Bible says, know that we are Christians. This is how we should operate. 2 Corinthians 5:7.
Mm-hmm.
We walk by faith and not by sight.
Yes.
So it is to look ahead to the victory and not at what is happening.
Yes.
So it says, so we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are unseen.
Yes.
For the things which are visible are seen. They are temporal, brief, and fleeting. Where you got to soon finish.
Yes, Lord.
Your struggle with finances is about to go clear. I prophesy over this life that this year will not end without you having a testimony.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This year will not end without you telling the story about how Jesus came this day and changed everything.
Yes.
Your daughter will not go astray. Your son will not go astray. It doesn't matter the mouth that is speaking. Jesus said, I am come. I am come today to overturn every negative word spoken over your children, over your child. It doesn't matter what she sees. Don't follow the world and speak. Speak what God says about your child. He said the seed of the righteous is mighty. The seed of the righteous is blessed. The seed of the righteous will overcome. Your seed will overcome. Your seed will make it. You will be proud. You will testify before this year is out. It doesn't matter the friend or the company that she's in. It doesn't matter the company that is pulling him astray. I prophesy life. In Jesus' name. For the things which are visible are temporal, just brief and fleeting. But the things which are invisible are everlasting and imperishable. Yeah. So the Bible here is telling about a seen realm and an unseen realm. Watch it. This is how I learn about it. So there's a spiritual world called the unseen realm, the spirit realm, or the supernatural realm. This unseen realm is responsible for many everyday happenings, both good and bad. If Christian can understand this, this unseen realm is responsible because everything that affects you in the natural first affects you in the realm of the spirit.
Yes.
And if we are blind to what is happening there, then here we will speak death consistently over our life. As a believer, the minute you are born again, it's not something good. Many pastors are guilty.
Yes, sir.
Many of us are guilty. Why? We make this Christian walk or this spiritual walk complicated for people. We make it hard. And we feel that it's only we alone must walk in it. That's a lie. That's an error. The minute you are born again as a child of God, your eyes are open to the realm. Your eyes are open. It's just that they don't teach you what to do. And purity is a way to maintain for you to operate both in the natural seen realm and the unseen spiritual realm. Purity is not hard. Trust me, they make it seem hard. So purity becomes where you struggle to dress, you struggle to do this, no, you don't have to struggle. Just get your mindset to where you are, a child of God. Begin to put value on yourself. As God value you enough that, watch this, when we were valueless, God sent his son, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Jesus came to redeem and to restore us to become like God. Many people, when they talk about repent, all they talk about repent is sin, and repent and turn to whatsoever degree. Repent is not only a change of nature. Repent is a change of the inner man. So the inner man, because of the presence of the Holy Spirit, he comes and bring God on the inside. So repent means to come back to God. Repent means to come back, to begin to operate, to think like God, to do. Every believer, there's no deliverance ministry. As much as I flew in that area, it's just, you know, you go to university and they say you major in an area and you minor in an area, so you major in one. My major, a part of it is deliverance, but it's not a ministry.
Whoa.
Because when we put it in a ministry, certain people, that it's not for them.
Yeah.
But Jesus said in Mark, come down to the end, 16, 17, thereabout, and him say, and these signs
Yes.
Shall follow them. It never said Pastor Errol White. Yes. It never said Prophet Mungo Boom.
Mm-hmm.
It never said Apostle Bongo Man.
Mm-hmm.
It said, and these signs shall follow them that believe. Mm-hmm. So everybody that believe have the ability and the insight to cast out demons.
Yes.
Casting out of demons is a norm for every believer.
Mm-hmm.
Casting out of demons, the thing is that our mindset is just that we don't renew a mindset to who we are now. So casting out of demon is mwah, mwah, mwah. That's why Jesus, when they come and say, even the demon strip, Jesus said, nobody rejoice about that man. Mm-hmm. Just think about your name that is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. That is the norm for everybody.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
So it's normal. It's normal, supernaturally. Normally, supernaturally for every believer, even walk on the road. As you walk upon the road, the Holy Spirit is there guiding you. And he says, speak to that lady. There's a spirit that is troubling that lady. And something is about her. Every believer.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, ma'am, how are you? How is everything?
Mm-hmm.
Why are you like this? Don't be. You know Jesus loves you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if Jesus didn't love me, all of this wouldn't be happening. And you would not true, you not know Jesus, no, me, I got you.
Mm-hmm.
He said, yes. But watch this now. Because, but you see, I talked to her. No, ma'am, because of this happening,
mm-hmm.
and that happening, doesn't mean that God, how do I know? God knows you.
Mm-hmm.
And God knows that if you continue this, right now you are contemplating suicide because you think that this ended there. She said, this is the Jesus I'm introducing you to.
Mm-hmm.
Are you a pastor? No.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just a child of God.
Mm-hmm.
You too can become a child of God and become an overcomer. God bless you. Pray fear, cast out depression, cast out every spirit that affect the woman. Go on and just pray for and say, find a Bible, believe in Jesus. You didn't invite her at your church.
Mm-hmm.
Because we want to tell some people, listen to me. There's a difference between ministry. There's a difference between church.
Mm.
Ministry is personal thing, and many take ministry personal thing that God give them and make it become a doctrine and form church.
Mm-hmm.
So you get people under your ministry. You hear them say ministry. You get people under your ministry, and so the people them stay under your ministry 15, 10, 20 years, and you never develop them because they are there building your ministry. But church, as according to Ephesians 4:12, and God gave to the church some apostle, prophet, or again, pastor, evangelist, teachers for the building up. So church is a place that you come into the body of Christ. I look and see your gifting, your ministry. I develop your ministry and your gifting, and I send you out to accomplish your ministry. That's it. That's church.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But we take it and we mix it. Errol White's ministry, and so people come, and I just see my ministry, so I become the star of this ministry, and everybody with their calling and gifting, because everybody come in the body of Christ have a gift.
Yes, sir.
Everybody come, as a matter of not in the church, everybody that is born, you're born with a gift, you're born with a talent, you're born with potentiality. There's something in you. That's why you are in the earth, to fulfill a destiny or a mandate. You're not here, oh Lord Jesus. Some people just have go on. You are more than that. You are far more than that.
Mm. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
This little child here is very brilliant. Is very talented. Is very gifted.
Yes.
Her IQ is very high.
Mm-hmm.
But it's how she thinks of herself and how she allows people. And it's what she has been through that makes her think dwarfed. But she's very big. The minute she realizes who she is in Christ, remember, you will see a new transformed child sitting before you. This one.
Yes, sir.
This one has a lot of potential.
Yes, sir.
And she has influence to attract people, a lot of people,
yes,
that God wants her to take out of her and to give. There's so much in her.
Yes, sir.
But it's because of what she has been through,
mm-hmm.
what she experienced, and how people look down upon her. A lot of people look down upon her. A lot of people talk over her. Bad. I cancel. I remove it.
Amen.
Every word that they speak. Every
yes,
word.
Lord.
Every word.
Amen.
I don't know if she's at university, but I see her in university doing well.
Mm. My God.
I see her in university doing extremely well.
Mm-hmm.
She will make a mark if she only understands what God put her here for. She not just put here for normal. Before she reached here, there was stuff that God imparted in her.
Yes.
But her parents never see that.
Yes.
So that's why you have to have godly parents.
Yes,
godly parents are what that sees what God placed in you and open the doors daily and for you to walk and be what God has.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Mm.
Let me just go on and Mr. Luanta. Watch this now. Kaya Basata. All right, so I started on a natural path first, right?
Yes.
That is getting saved, being a member. Was never taught that getting saved is not really natural but spiritual. That's where I started. When I got saved, I spent 10 years at a church. That's my first church. It was all natural. One day I sat on the rostrum of the church. I was a minister. I sat. And when I sat, the Lord began to speak to me. I said, God, no, sir. I couldn't stay at the church. I'm being honest. The church, natural.
Mm-hmm.
When the Lord began to show me, the church is about 60 to 70 years. It has branches all over. Half is spiritual, half is natural.
Mm-hmm.
Why do I say that? Half believe in tongues,
mm-hmm.
half does not believe.
Mm-hmm.
Half believe in wearing pants and certain things, half does not believe. So half old, half new. That was it. And watch this, what begin to happen. The half that don't wear pants, that don't wear jewel, that make your face dry like coconut brush.
Mm-hmm.
Not forgetting that people have for work, people have for put themselves together.
Mm-hmm.
So they want people, don't put on makeup, don't wear that. That's another thing, you know.
Yes, sir.
They don't even want to buy some ear for make your ear must look like brush, dry and trashy.
So what about the people them with alopecia? So them not
when, you know,
when the ear come out the ear, them a lose ear.
Mm.
So those people, you know, sir.
No, them say you're a Christian. If you put on ear, you're sin.
Yes.
That's rubbish. That's rubbish.
I swear they gonna get you.
The African would say nonsense.
Yes,
rubbish. Me, I recommend people, while you're here, fix up yourself.
Mm-hmm.
One day I said to a woman, I said, you know this? She said, what, sir? I said, let me show you. Let me take you out.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Me say, you're a child of God. She said, yes. Mm-hmm. Me say, you're witness to people. She said, yeah. Me say, you know what this name? Me say, look here. Go buy one and fix your lip. So then dry.
Lip balm.
Not even that some Christian one wear.
That is true, sir.
With your dry lip, but you go tell people about Christian. Keep your dry lip and your dry lip Christian Jesus to yourself.
That's true, sir.
Bro, you come about tell people about Jesus and you look like, you remember our JUTC bus, you never banned them there. The JUTC bus look popped down and dirty. Let me just continue, yeah, man.
Yes, sir.
It was while developing a habit of reading the word of God, I met Jesus. That's how I met Jesus. And that's why I tell people, if you look at the Bible as Bible and books, it will be boring.
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at the Bible being a spiritual book, that every time you enter, when you're reading, you have entered another realm. It's another realm.
Mm-hmm.
And in this realm, impartations
mm-hmm.
come, transference of gifts and other thing is come. So when you read the Bible, look at it as a book now. You have entered a place with Jesus and with God. You will know him more. You will know how to treat him. You will know what to do to keep and maintain a life of purity.
Yes, sir.
That's how I start. I met Jesus. I begin to understand the Bible is not just any book, but a spiritual book. And the more I read is the more I am imparted with spiritual realities and transference from the spirit by the Holy Ghost. So I start to understand that now. Watch this. My spirit man just start to grow strong.
Mm.
Then I can discern things by me, ERROL, not knowing. But something in me tell me, no, I can differentiate good and bad. I can differentiate good and bad. You understand? I learned that. Oh, so I must tell you before the last part of this.
Yes, sir.
All right, Jesus in person. You see how much thing me I tell you? Watch this now. About spiritual and natural. Watch this. I went into, let me find the one and done with this. Where am I there? I went into the, I got a dream. In the dream, the house that I was living at the time, when I looked in the dream, the house was up for sale. But in the natural, there was no sale. When I came out from the dream, and thing, I never understand dreams. But 6 months after, the house was sold. The same sign from Victoria Mutual Building Society and the phone number, everything, is the same sign end up at the gate. So now me understand that our life is affected.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You see that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just the other day, a lady, she came on. Jesus, give me a little time. Let me just do that little part. You know? Mm-hmm. A lady, she's called me. She said, "Sir, I want to tell you something. This is what has been happening to me. I listen to your life. You said, Holy Spirit, you are my victory. Holy Spirit, you are my victory. Reveal whatever is happening to me." I never know the lady have cancer. Cancer of the womb. Mm-hmm. She said she go to doctor. Doctor can't find anything. Can't do scan. But she carry a stench. Everywhere she go, people smell the stench. And she said, "Sir, rotten flesh is dropping from my womb."
Yeah.
She said, "When I begin to say, Holy Spirit, you are my victory," she said, "I entered a dream and a man appeared to me." And the man said, "Oh, you can't dead. You know, from when me I try kill you,
Jesus,
and me put cancer in your womb for rotting out the whole hand that you feel dead. And then you go to the doctor and they give you a bad injection. You feel dead. Me not like you. Me not like your family." The woman come out and she said, more than ever, like tablet. She started, "Holy Spirit, you are my victory. Bring healing, restoration to my body. Overturn whatever anybody do. Holy Spirit." She said. No, she called it a day. My wife was there. She said to me, "Say, Pastor, you don't know what? No flesh now drop no more."
Yes, God.
She said, "Pastor, the bleeding issue, stop. The scent, stinking scent, rotten scent, stop. Gone. I am being healed. I'm being there. I'm a nasty pastor."
Yes.
Quickly. So many people don't understand that spirits have a mark. Let me start here. So even Jesus and Paul say, "I bear in my body a mark."
Yes.
And it is not a physical mark. Spirits have tattoos, and those things that we are engraving into the body are actually access points, just like what you say.
Mm-hmm.
So they are really what? Access points.
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right. Hallelujah. Ready. All right. Tattoo is a confusion of the soul. Tattoo is a confusion of the soul. It's the soul. When you see a man begin to put many tattoos on his body, it is not the man. Many spirits are oppressing and harassing and even possessing that man. So it's spirit that tells him, "Go, put this on." A lady the other day was asking, she have a boyfriend. She put her boyfriend picture and in face right big up in her neck. Yeah, so write him name. In less than 1 month, the boyfriend left her gone to somebody. Now she's asking how much it costs to take it off.
"Sir, me have somebody have an ex for me treated. And sometimes I go and make good dreams to the same person. That's why I'm asking if the tattoos have anything to do with dreams."
Yes, man. So remember, they are access points. Yeah. So who leave, they have access still.
My God.
But may I give you a way out? Don't forget to spend money for laser it off, because we already have that here.
Yeah.
The access point you have allowed with those things, tattoo, piercing, they are the token of having formed a covenant with spirits.
Jesus.
So really and truly, when a tattoo and body piercing is a token, a covenant you have entered with spirits.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
There's some people have some tattoo. I have a tattoo that is peeping through, like peeping through a tree. And I realize I have to deal with these monitoring spirits. You know, always I dream to people are peeping somewhere.
At you. No, man, they can tell you off. Maybe just finish and done. Watch this now. So you make covenant and you have just given those spirits, given to those spirits to come in and out of your body whenever they please. So that spirit doesn't need to ask for permission. Some they ask, they don't know because it's a door for them.
Mm.
As we are moved to go and draw tattoo, it's a spirit of violence that enters a man. That spirit will move you to go and draw a particular type of tattoo and will also tell you where to put it in the body for access point or gateway or portal for entry. That's why when Jesus encounters a man, he need to break the power of that covenant. As long as that tattoo is on your body, when violence comes, you will always be moved to act accordingly because you have made a covenant with the spirit of violence.
Yes.
When a spirit of fornication enters, and I believe that's where there's no, that's why there's no prostitute without a tattoo. Mm. That spirit wants access to their bodies. So it will move them to draw or engrave something that will signify an access point into their body. So they just have sold themselves unto that spirit. So that spirit no longer needs permission, for that tattoo now becomes the access point for that spirit. Have you ever seen a Christian, a believer, a child of God without a tattoo? The elect of God going to draw a tattoo? No. Right? This is where it should be. The Holy Ghost within. Watch this now. Since you give your life, have you ever felt like you want one more?
No.
Watch this now. The Holy Ghost within. It's a spirit.
Mm-hmm.
It's a ghost. Mm-hmm. So the Holy Spirit will not move you
mm-hmm.
in that direction.
Yes.
And the Holy Ghost within will not permit to function that way because your tattoo, no, the mark that you bear, Maya Dale Kosata. Where Paul say, I bear in my body
the mark. Jesus.
So that's your tattoo now, Alabon. Mm. And it's not a physical, but a spiritual thing, Kayabon. So that's your mark now. Oh, Jesus. But there's no worldly musician or rapper without a tattoo. Mm. So when you see one this way, just know that they have been taken over with many spirits that confuse them. And that's why you have certain shows and certain things now, whereby the spirits know when it comes in, it tells them how to sing, what to do, what incantation to do. So it gets people. And when it gets the people now are affected, they are imparted, or a transference take place at that concert, and they go now to get the mark like the artist, and to get the this, and to get because it looked nice. But it's really a spirit that was transferred. And the same thing people now understand, I think it's Beyonce, one of them. She said when she goes on the stage, this is not her, she don't this, it's another spirit called Sasha Fierce that comes. And this girl will do all manner of things which she will never do. Mm-hmm. So it's a spirit, and now that's such a fierce. So it's a spirit from somebody that never get to live out or fulfill that destiny. So that spirit now comes in through the tattoo and the thing to fulfill what they should. They never get to do.
Yes. Sir, we're going to take a commercial break and sir, coming back to finish up.
Yes.
Sheena Power Talk.
Hey Power Gang, remember to get your book on Amazon today. No other day but today. You can get it in Kindle form and you can get it in paperback form. And if you are in Jamaica and you want a copy of this amazing book, The Crown and the Cross, listen to me. Call me at 1-876-429-6004. Listen Power Gang, you must have one of these books. Come on now, Crown and the Cross.
Go ahead, sir.
All right. So basically, that's what it is. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to do two things.
Sir, you know you have to pray before you leave here.
Yeah, man, I'm going to pray. But I'm just try finding the way how to pray.
Yes, sir. Sir,
so we're going to break some covenants with people that you get a tattoo and you know a Christian, but for some other reason, it's still affecting your life, affecting your destiny, affecting progress. It can affect marital success.
Mm.
It can affect marital success, trust me. Because these demons, they are wicked.
Yes, sir.
They are wicked, but we just don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
They just don't understand.
Yes.
The amount of testimonies I get, I have a young girl now, for God, fine, that was molested how much years. Suicidal, and she was promiscuous, she was all over the place. And I have she waiting, I tell them, give me some time, because them, there's something they don't take. Them not hard,
mm-hmm.
them not hard still. Because there's a girl that had some tattoo overseas. The girl spent $450,000 for try to get rid of the spirits. What happened after a time? The spirits start to visit her in the night.
Mm-hmm.
And it's more than one. It was one at first. Then it's male and female. And sometime all seven come. So they have sex with this young lady in the anus and in the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Oral sex wrong.
Serious?
Oral sex wrong.
Aye.
Oral sex wrong.
So, sir, to the even to the people that are married, that
the Bible say, marriage is honorable,
mm-hmm.
and the bed
is
undefiled. But there are things that we can bring in to the bed that makes it defiled.
Jesus.
Oral sex. Oral sex after time leads to anal sex. There are two spirit that works hand in hand.
So not to the like when we are talking among our friends, I tell you the truth, sir. We are talking so we have to do them things in our marriage.
Well, I know. But that's where I'm coming from. I'm telling you where I'm coming from.
Yes, sir.
I'm telling you, my mouth was like, wait a name there. Every woman missing me want to eat. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit is the one that stops me,
yes.
even from masturbation. It's the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
I remember I was in my bathroom as a young Christian going, I was masturbating, and the light came right through the window, the bathroom window, and the voice said to me, son, you are more than that now. You are my, like when I say, you are my own, my representative. You host me. Your body is the temple of God. I live there.
Mm-hmm.
Do not. This is a sign to defile. I take every video. I take every book. I take every tape. And I took them out and I burned them from that day until now. When we say masturbation, everywhere we go, when I was in the art school, when I was in the army, me dey pour my bed of wine.
Mm-hmm.
I try broke. Me leave out go bed. Go broke. Let me tell you. We can overcome it. Yeah, one other time I tell you how deep oral sex is. It's very, 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 very. And oral sex takes on the spirit of animals. Also, carrying vibrator in your room. I know of a pastor who sell them and encourage them to spice up what kind of life. Don't take pornography, but you spice up life. Rubbish. You are opening doors and portals through pornography to enter your marriage,
yes,
and to scatter your marriage.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
When you use vibrator, dildos, let me tell you what this does. And you set pool for dance upon the pool for entertain your husband. These are antennas. These are antennas that open the realm that calls spirit to come in. And the spirit will make you each time become more perverted than normal. You want to try something that you never try. Next thing, all of a sudden, you want to try twosome, onesome, threesome, fivesome. Then you want wife swapping and all them things. Oral sex is one of the doors that opens to perversion. It takes you down a deeper road. Then all of a sudden, no, you don't want to lick the front, you want to lick the back. Because when you lick the back, there is sensitivity.
Hey, sir, trip me up.
So wherever you are, take that out of your house. Take it out.
Yes, sir.
Trust me, take it out. I have learned. So what I have to do is reprogram my mind. Mm-hmm. No, for my wife, no. I have to learn sensitive areas. There are many other areas that are very sensitive and aromatic, if that's what it's called. When you touch them, when you put in the Bible, Solomon tell you what areas to touch, what areas not to touch. When them talk about, then Solomon never said, come into the garden and eat out the garden. Eat out what's in the garden. Rubbish. Don't let nobody. People. Solomon said, she opened her legs and he come into the garden and eat and spring the garden. Rubbish. That affects purity. That contaminates purity. Mm. Let me tell you, if you want to be pure, yeah, I used to eat out a garden. And I learned. The Holy Spirit tells me, and he begins to show me some stuff, what oral sex leads to. And after a time, oral sex begin to cause you and your partner. All of a sudden, there are urges that it opens for get other partners. Mm. It's very deep. At another time, and she not power talk. I will go into oral sex. I will go into anal sex. I will go into all other type of sex. Spin me pon the fan. Make me spin pon the fan. Make me roll. Make me this. I will show you.
Sister, you have positioned the wrong too?
Yes, man. Wait a minute, but tell me about... It tells about you can kiss the feet. You can kiss the here, so the calf. You can kiss the leg up to between the thighs. You can kiss the belly, the breast, the navel, certain areas. It's in thing. And it shows your position is not only missionary. You can climb the tree when you hold the tree and hold your holy wife and climb her. It's in Solomon.
Sister, I just was going to ask you about Solomon because I hear somebody said lick the nectar of the fruit or whatever.
Leave the nectar, another nectar there. Leave the woman neck. When you say and she have bring out juice and you call it nectar. Rubbish. That's a show to trap people, trap your marriage life, to scatter your marriage, to bring animosity in your marriage. Let me tell you about use dildo for spice up. After dildo, in Romans 1, it tells you dildo is an unnatural stuff. Once you put an unnatural stuff in a natural stuff, it breaks. So you don't want the natural stuff, you want the unnatural stuff. And that's why, watch this.
Oh, sir, my let me just God. Pray. Oh, sir, we have come down, but man.
I love Jesus. It's a lot of stuff I, Errol White, was doing that's wrong. Mm. You hear? I was following the world and them tell me it's okay. Even people that are not married, I was told by deacons and ministers that it's okay to operate from the head to the waist. That means I can kiss, I can fondle, I can nibble ears, I can suck breasts, I can do things. It's wrong. Sir, probably the person breast I am sucking is not my wife.
Oh. Sir, what if your wife is okay?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm talking unmarried. Oh. As a single people.
Oh.
Single people are touching and flirting and doing
stuff. Yes, sir. That's what I heard. So we can do a little touch.
Yes.
A little feel.
Yes, man. Yes. You are opening portals. You are opening portals. Our life is more spiritual than natural. You are opening portal. Yes, man, we are engaged. So that's okay. We can go. I tell you of a lady that was engaged to a man. And this man, watch this. This woman was on fire for God. Single woman, nice woman, full of shape, everything. Good man. When this woman prayed, trust me, man, place jerk. And we did not know the spiritual side to it. Whereby when she prayed, the demonic world quake. So from the marine kingdom, witchcraft and marine kingdom come together. They work hand in hand. The marine kingdom is stronger than witchcraft. But they work hand to hand. So what they did, they said, we want a man. So the witchcraft find a man. And they find a man from the water that is connected to the marine kingdom. And so they put the man and they cause situation for them to meet. And they gave the man money and wealth and car. The man never have it. And when the man get it, and the man meet the lady, him start to give the mother and the brothers and sisters a lot of stuff and wealth and shed upon them. So all of a sudden, they like the man. They like the man because the man is a godly man or an ungodly. They like what they are getting. Mm-hmm. So they said, they force the woman to talk to the man. And the woman start to like the man. She never like him because everything she asks God about. But now because pressure come, she start to like the man. One day the man rent a nice place at a nice hotel, top hotel, 5-star. And the man said, we're going to stay a night. She went there, even though the Holy Spirit was telling her no. Her conscience was saying no. She went there at the time. And while they were there, the man stripped. In the room where the man was, where were marine spirits and witchcraft spirits waiting for the girl to fall, to out her light. And while she was there, she come out in her see-through thing. And when she stand, no, and the man said, yes, him lie down. Them said, yes, we have her now. When she sat on the bed, she said, can I just pray one more time? Him said, why? God understand. God knew that we'll be getting married, but the marriage was, it was an assignment to destroy her life and her destiny. We have to be careful as Christian, and it happened to me.
Mm-hmm.
So me not tell you where me hear or me see it happen to me. The Lord revealed it to me.
Yes, sir.
So while she there, she said, can I pray one more time? She begin to pray normal. Then the spirit of prayer come on her. She begin to pray. The first thing that went is the marine spirit and the demons that was there. When the guy opened him eye and him look, him not see no demon. You know him do? Take up him clothes and run out of the hotel room.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how that was uncovered and she was peered.
Amen.
Be careful who you connect yourself to.
Jesus.
Yeah, yeah?
Be careful who you
from our assignments. Yeah, me, I don't know. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So, all right. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you thanks. I thank you for this opportunity to share Jesus. I thank you for this opportunity from your daughter to come and to just explore. Pause and to advance the kingdom of God in this time, in this season. First, may your hand rest upon your daughter.
Yes, ma'am.
God, may every resources necessary, every people required and is necessary for her to function and to expand and to be greater, where she will not only impact Jamaica but the world with the gospel. I command every resources necessary. May lack insufficiency never be your portion in the name of Jesus. May men arise. May men, the gifts of men, arise from the north, the east, the south, the west, to locate her. Now, everything that she needs that is held back in obscurity, that is tied up, I lose it. I lose it in the name of Jesus Christ. And that from this day, God, telephone calls, emails will be coming forth, God, to expand, to increase, to supply every need, whether for ministry, whether for private life, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. I lift her and I lift her hands right now in Jesus' name. And Lord, for every person that is watching concerning tattoos, every evil covenant, every evil soul tie and covenant with marine spirits, ooh, with witchcraft spirits, anything these tattoo are named, God, any evil soul tie and covenant, I break that connection, every card, every door that is open to any spirit anywhere from the past concerning these tattoos, by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ and the fire of the Holy Ghost, I disconnect, and I close that door, seal it with the blood of Jesus. No more will you enter through these to affect their dreams. No more will you enter through to harass our trouble. I break your power now. Wherever you are, listen to me now. I break your power. Go from their life. Never, never, never to trouble, torment, harass. Leave their future, leave their money, whatever you hold for them, any good thing that God has predestined for them to enter, and you hold it. I break your arm, loose it. I said, let it go. Let it go. Leave the money, leave the business, leave the schooling, leave Jesus. The man, let him go, let him go, let him go. I prophesy potential future marriage. Ooh. I release it. Wherever you have owned that man because of your tattoo, because of the past, I sever by the sword of the Spirit now. Go! Go! Go!
Jesus.
Loose your hold. I declare it is well. Father, I declare over your people that they are for blessing and not cursing in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare that you have purchased their freedom from the curse of the law and all its condemnation by offering yourself as a curse. I declare that they can no longer labor under the burden of the law, for they are now become saints, lively stone, built up spiritual stone, holy, pure priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifice accepted to God by Christ. I declare that they are a chosen generation, royal priesthood, a peculiar person that shows forth your praise. God, taponde. I declare that the name of Jesus Christ is given unto everyone now listening to exercise authority in three different worlds, the earth, the seas, and beneath the earth. For the Bible says God has highly exalted him and has freely bestowed upon him the name that is above every name. So when they pronounce and declare your name, it becomes a strong tower. It makes everything against their prayers in the heavenlies to bow. It makes everything, makosata, in the earth and the seas beneath the earth, God, to the authority of the name, will bow to them. I elevate life wherever you are. I elevate your life in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, I take authority over the heavens, the seas, the earth beneath the earth, and the things in them. I destroy with the sword of the Spirit every dark person that is poised to stand against their life, their success, their future, their destiny, or to reinforce anything evil against them. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare it is written that Christ has set them free. I declare that they are free indeed. I declare that you are free indeed right now in the name of Jesus. You are free from every ancestral curse of untimely death. You are free from every ancestral curse of premature death, ancestral curse of marital destruction or frustration, ancestral curse of poverty, financial handicap, infirmities, and failure at the edge of breakthrough. Now, by the blood of Jesus, I declare that there is no condemnation for you, that you are in Christ. You walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. And the law of the Spirit of life, Christ Jesus, had made you free from the law of sin and death. I confess that every ancestral dedication of children to idols, God's sacred waters and trees in your family lineage is broken, destroyed now by fire in the name of Jesus. I declare that you shall not suffer for the sins of your forefathers. Everyone shall bear his own iniquity, and by the blood of Jesus Christ, every unconscious covenant with familiar spirit in your family, break loose them, break loose them, break loose them by the power and the blood of Jesus. I decree that every curse of sexual immorality over your life as a result of incest, as a result of lesbianism, homosexual, bestiality, fornication, adultery, oral sex, abortion, sexual sins of your father, sexual iniquities of your mother, break now. Mm-hmm. Break by the power and the blood. Break. Let them go. Mm. The mighty name of Jesus. For Christ was bruised for their transgression. Every curse affecting their dwelling place. Every curse affecting their dwelling place. Every curse affecting their position. Every curse affecting their properties as a result of past ritual and sacrifice performed on them shall break now by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. It is written that life and death are in the power of the tongue. And by the words of my mouth and their mouth, we shall condemn, we shall be condemned and justified. Every curse, place on your life. Every curse, place on your property. Every curse, place on your destiny through witchcraft, through spells, through jinx, enchantments, and incantation. Break now. Break.
Break
now.
Break
by the blood of Jesus Christ. Every curse that you are personally attracted to your life through your action, through your promises, vows, oaths, and negative confession,
break!
Set you free.
Break!
As you listen, may testimony be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every curse activated through your personal sins, be removed by the blood of Jesus Christ. Be removed now in the name of Jesus. In the place of the curse that ever affects you, I confess this scripture, and I have peace through the blood of his cross by him to reconcile all things unto himself. I confess that everything that pertains to you is reconciled to Christ Jesus now. And the Lord will give you strength. He will bless you and your household with peace. The Lord God will bless you as he promised you. You shall lend unto many nations. You shall not borrow. You shall reign over many nations. Ooh, the Lord shall open Jesus unto you his good treasure. The heavens shall give rain in your land, in your season. I bless all the works of your hands. Iwekata, wherever you are, as you lift them, I bless the works of your hands now in the name of Jesus. And I declare that the Lord shall cause your enemies who rise up against you to be defeated before your face. The Lord shall come out against them. Mandeka, they shall come out against you one way and shall be defeated before you seven different ways. The Lord will establish you as a holy, pure person to himself as he has spoken. I declare you are the head and not the tail. Bless! Yeah. Shall be your land, your storehouse, your business place, your children, your dwelling place, and the works of your hand. The Lord shall not allow destruction and peril to come upon you all the days of your life. I seal these words. I seal them by the power and the blood of Jesus and the fire of God. As I blow this shofar, I command angels, to deliver, to set you free, to set your house free, to set your captives free, to set you wherever they have tied you, wherever they have buried you. I break every chain. I break witchcraft power. I break every connection, anything of your past that affects your future. I break and I cut you off in the mighty name of the angels of the Lord. Go now, deliver, overturn and elevate in Jesus' name. Testify.
Hallelujah.
May you testify.
Hallelujah.
May you testify. May good news be your portion. May good news, may benefits, foreign benefits, local benefits be your portion. May this year not end without you testifying, without you dancing. May a shift be released. Kai so cabron. Zimboko Sati Prondeska Lande El Caputa Nile Yukunda Saprande. Father, I thank you. I thank you for testimonies, and I thank you for elevating your daughter's life to another realm in you. Thank you, God, for a bigger connection. Even though you are here, I'm opening the door that you are here, but you will be connected to like a television station or one of them network that will join forces. So whenever you go live, they will want your thing to put there so that others, you will make a mark. You will be invited overseas. Get ready. You'll be invited overseas. Get ready. Get ready for overseas connection. Get ready. This is just a small portion of what God has started and is about to do in your life. The shift takes place right now.
Hey!
In Jesus' name.
Jesus. Glory to God. Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Man of God, I know that persons are watching right now, and I know beyond just being so blessed, And I know that the anointing is rocking wherever they are right now, but I know they want to know where to find you, where you're at, what you're doing. Can you just tell them where on social media you are, where to find you? Is there a ministry number that they can call? People of God, listen to me, reach out and bless the man of God. He has poured out today, and I know he got a lot more, and I'm praying that God will release him one more time to come back to Sheena Power Talk. Man of God, please tell them where to find you.
All right. I haven't started a church as yet. So I do live, and I'm on TikTok. I'm on Instagram. I'm on Facebook presently. I'm on a radio channel called Live Deliverance Internet Radio with Apostle Emmett Overton. This radio station, so locals and overseas, you can go on it. That's Live Deliverance, www.livedeliverance.com. This beams me into 15 or 20 nations most night. So like tonight when I go Bible studies, I'm being beamed into 20 other nations. Trust me, you will hear me call their name out. They are live, they are watching. So I am there. You can join me every Monday, every Thursday on these platforms, 8 p.m. I'm always there for now. That's what I do. I have a book called, sorry, I didn't take it. It's called Pray Your Way Through. This book is not just a normal prayer book. Trust me. God has teach me how to use words to pray. I can just read a scripture and I get a prayer point. So just like what you hear me say, this book has everyone. If you want to get pregnant, it's there. If you're pregnant and you want to travel, it is there. If you want to get married, it is there. If you have a mind issue, it is there. Deliverance of the mind. Marine kingdom, wealth must change. And so if you're struggling, there's a prayer there. Wealth must change. It is there. It's $3,000 Jamaican, but you can get me on Amazon. You can go to Amazon and you can get it there on Amazon. It is there also. And there's a new book coming out titled How to Walk in the Spirit. I think that's it.
Yeah.
You may not have so much. And you can go to my YouTube channel. There's a lot of stuff there that will help you, and prayers just like this one that will help. That's ERROL White and YouTube. Go and subscribe. And let me know, and I will get back to you, all right?
Glory to God. And guess what? All this information will be on screen, so please go and support the man of God. Pastor Papa, thank you so much. I appreciate you, and I'm looking forward to having
you. It's an honor, you know, because, you know, a lot of people say, boy, Sheena, I hear it, and Sheena talks so much about you, and every minute she talks about you, and Sheena does talk about you, and so forth. That's so good. Just like, oh, this lady, what's her name from? Prophet Carter, Evangelist Stroud. She talks and said, I ministered to her in a certain way too. I can't remember neither. And she said, how could you not forget?
Man of God, thank you so much for all the work.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
So long, my holy out.
Yes. Blessing, sir. And Power Gang, thank you so much for joining us today. God bless you.
Sheena Power Talk.
Hey Power Gang, remember to get your book on Amazon today, no other day but today. You can get it in Kindle form and you can get it in paperback form. And if you are in Jamaica and you want a copy of this amazing book, The Crown and the Cross, listen to me, call me at 1-876-429-6004. Listen Power Gang, you must have one of these books. Come on now, Crown and the Cross. Hey beauties and cuties, thank you so much for being a part of Sheena Power Talk Youth Link. I trust that your soul is edified, Satan is terrified, and God is glorified. If you want to be a part of this amazing move, this divine move, you can always call me or contact me on any social media handles. Don't keep that story to yourself. Let it out. Let yourself be free and free somebody else. Share your story today on Sheena Power Gang. Listen to me, Power Team. power, gang. We are causing an eruption in the earth. We are called for revival. And God has set the nigger and broke out in our life. In Jesus' name, let it be well. God bless you. And please remember, if you do want to sow, if you do want to help this ministry monetary, you can always contact me. You can always get me through Cash App or other different means like Western Union, MoneyGram, anything and any way you want to sow and make an offering to what God is doing. I would really appreciate it. There are things that we need as we develop, and we trust that you will be generous to us as the Lord will lead you. Thank you so much for making it Sheena Power Gang. You don't know how big things are going on Sheena Power Gang, and Power Gang gonna lead. God bless you. God keep.